AR, and the third number would be AR square, and so on. So in general, the nth term can be found as AR raised to n minus 1, obviously, right? You had all studied it too. Now, a C program calls the following ARM assembly language function to compute TN. So EXT, extern, what is the meaning of extern? Extern simply means this function is declared without having a definition. Your definition is not found in your C code. It is found in some other place. Like for example, in this case, it is in a separate assembly language file, a .s file, right? So this is just telling the compiler, okay, go ahead and use it. Don't bother where the definition is. It will be there somewhere. So that is the idea of extern. In strict C terminology, it allows us to declare and use a function without defining it explicitly. Now, where parameters have the defined meanings defined above. So you have A, R, and N. So
those are the three parameters in the function. So we are supposed to write an assembly language function which computes and returns TN. So nth term, once we are provided with A, R, and N. Okay, to make your job a bit, or life a bit more difficult, the R raised to n minus 1 term should be calculated using an assembly language subroutine called powerless 1. So you cannot simply write one single routine, you need to call the subroutine powerless 1 to implement
R raised to n minus 1. Assume A and R are integers that can be positive, 0, or negative. N is greater than 0. And TN is within the permissible range of the processor.
So A and R could be positive, 0, or negative. And N is strictly greater than 0. And TN, that is the term, nth term that you compute, is guaranteed to be within the permissible range, which means you wouldn't have any issues like overflow. Okay? So the required term can always be stored in 32 bits. So you don't have to worry about it overflowing. So this is what we are supposed to do. It's a very, very straightforward question, except for, you know, the requirement to use the so-called subroutine. Okay, so let's give it a try. At first, to get started, I will just write powerless one first, which is a subroutine. What is a subroutine? It's like a function which is called from within a function. So we are implementing a function, and that function itself calls another function to do something, right? So let us write it. So the function we are supposed to implement is geometric. So it is called from C language. So in assembly language, it will be declared just as a label, okay? And then you have it, and somewhere here you will have a subroutine, powerless one. So how will you call the subroutine? What is the instruction used to call a subroutine? BL, branch with link. So BL, powerless one. And somewhere in the memory, somewhere downstairs, you need to have powerless one. So that is a label. So when this instruction is executed, we will have a branch to this location, and the program counter value, that is the program, the next address of the next instruction to be executed, will be deposited in R14. Clear? And that is what BL does, right? In addition to taking the branch, it will put the current PC value, which is the next address of the next instruction to be executed, into R14. And then we will jump here, go all the way, and the last line would be BXLR. And this BXLR will cause the control to jump to the line after the line which called the subroutine, and your execution continues. And the very last line would be BXLR. And this will allow you to return to your C program. But when you do this, there are some things you have to be careful about. The first thing is, you have to do push of a bunch of registers. And before BXLR, you should pop a bunch of registers, which are modified by your program. Okay? So, what all registers should be there inside the push list?
The registers.
In assignment 1, a lot of you made the mistake of, you know, just pushing everything possible. Don't do that. Push only those registers which are modified by your routine or subroutine. That is, only those registers which are modified by your function and which are not used by the main program to pass parameters should be pushed. So in this case, should I push R0? No. R0, R1 and R2 need not be pushed in this case. Why? Because we are getting 3 parameters, those 3 parameters would be in the first 3 registers. So any and every register from R4 onwards that you use, sorry, R3 onwards, R0, R1, R2 are not pushed. So R3 to the highest register that you used should be pushed. And the pop should be exact of push, except for the difference push pop. Okay, this is so that you will pop exactly in the reverse order that you push. And that's not it. Here also you have to be worried, because this subroutine, even though in this case it is called only from your geometric function, technically could be called from anywhere, because this powerless one is just like another function, right? So all the stuff that you modify, all the registers that you modify inside the powerless one should be pushed at the beginning of powerless one. Treat powerless one just like another function. Right? Yeah. So what all need to be pushed? Again, all the registers that are modified by powerless one, except those registers which are used to pass parameters to powerless one. So for the function powerless one or subroutine powerless one, you pass some parameters. In this case, the powerless one is supposed to calculate R raised to n minus 1. Right? So it is supposed to get 2 parameters, R and N. So all the registers that you modify from R2 onwards needs to be pushed. R0 and R1 need not be pushed, because R0 and R1 are used to pass parameters. So any and every register from R2 to the biggest register that you use should be pushed. But in addition here, you should push one more, which is that one, R14. What will happen if you don't push R14? Not here, sorry. R14 should be pushed before calling the subroutine, not inside the subroutine. Inside the subroutine, it will be just like a function, all the registers that you use. But before you call this BL powerless one, you should push R14. Why should you push R14? Yeah, because the moment you call a BL from within this function, it will override the current R14. Why do you need the current R14? Yeah, to return to the C program. This last line in the geometric program, BXLR, uses R14. So if you overwrite R14, you will lose a sense of where you want to return to. You will not be returning to where you got started from, right? So somewhere here, you should put R14. And somewhere before BXLR, you should pop it. Okay, so a good practice is, whenever your function uses a subroutine, just push R14 in the beginning.